Hi, I'm Graeme Cowan, and for the last 5 years, I've been obsessed about how you can bounce back from tough times. Ever since I've written my book, Back from the Brink, and interviewed over 5,000 people, I've come to use a model called a moodometer, and you can see it here. And it's natural for things to slide down the moodometer. We lose our job, we get divorced, we lose a loved one, and it's not sliding down per se, which is bad. It's how quickly we come back up. Now, as you may recall, I came from the corporate world. I was a marketing manager with Johnson & Johnson and Pfizer, worked in recruitment, outplacement, culture change with Morgan & Banks, before becoming joint managing director with A.T. Kearney. And I've always suspected that there were thriving tribes and depressed tribes. And a client of mine, the CEO of a large insurance company, gave me this book, Tribal Leadership by Dave Logan et al. What that shows is that tribes do indeed have moods, and that there are five different potential levels or stages. The first one is stage one. This is really dysfunctional. This is like the prison, and the only thing you can do really is to leave the tribe. It's that bad. The second stage is my life sucks. And this is where you feel like a victim, you blame other people, but it's a very large part of organizations. 25% fall into this category. This is where you have high turnover, where you have absenteeism, presenteeism. Now what you do, this is like the office. And what you need to do as a leader is to work with the ringleaders, to work with people that want to move and want to improve and take them up. That takes you up to the third stage, which is 49% of organizations, and that is, I'm great. Now, this looks quite good because people are motivated, they're trained, and they're striving. The problem is, when you say, I'm great, by implication, you're saying, and you're not. And so that means that there's often unhealthy competition, there's silos between groups, people hoard information. And the only way to progress an I'm great culture is to have shared values, take people and a shared purpose, and take them to where great, work on something bigger than just one person can handle. Stage four, where great, is where wonderful things happen. Anyone can lead, people understand each other's strengths and collaborate well together. It's wonderful. Stage five is where someone decides to change the world. And a good example of that is my friend Gavin Larkin, who was a successful chief executive, but decided also to start Are You OK Day. Wonderful things happen in stage five. So what is it about stage four and stage five tribes? Well, what they do differently is that they balance the collective mood of the tribe plus the performance. And the McKinsey partner Scott Keller showed that in his book, Beyond Performance, that organizations that do that and tribes that do that have a 220% greater chance of being in the top quartile of profitability. What else is great about thriving tribes? Well, for one, they're 300% more creative. They're 31% more productive, and they sell 37% more, which has been documented in the February edition of Harvard Business Review. So if you would like your tribe to outlast, outperform, and outmaneuver, and would like to know more about the Thriving Tribe process, please contact me via the email and number, phone number on the screen. This is Graeme Cowan, reminding us all that we need to strive to thrive.